Back, it's a new year, new things, but let's get to it. What if we forget to use antifreeze? Let's look at the definition of it. Antifreeze is a liquid that is added to the water in the engine's cooling system in order to lower the freezing point, as well as preventing water from freezing up. Antifreeze raises the boiling point of an engine coolant to prevent overheating. See, the number one killer in the world is stress, leads to everything else. Sex, drugs, money, all types of stuff and everything like that. And God was teaching me, he said suicide, depression, anxiety is a perspective. See, I used to have a lot of anxiety. It used to really bother me. I mean, you would never thought, especially like in high school and talking in front of people and everything like that. But God helped me. God said in his word says, in our weaknesses, his power is made perfect. But see, God can get rid of that anxiety. I don't have that anymore. I used to have chest pains where my chest would be like somebody was smashing it or anything like that. But it was my perspective. Hebrews 4 and 12. For the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even the dividing asunder of the soul and spirit and of the joints, marrow, and is discerner of the thoughts and intents of the heart. See, what happens is, in cars, it can't, it's water, but it definitely needs antifreeze, but imagine, any type of car, it needs antifreeze, no matter how much it costs. But unless you have like electric car or something, but I guess you still need antifreeze too. But imagine in life, that's what we're going through, and we never use antifreeze, and we just going through that. But imagine like the word of God is like the antifreeze that helps us be cool. Jeremiah 23 and 29. It is not my word like fire, declares the Lord, like a hammer that smashes a rock. Ephesians 6 and 17. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. See, a lot of us ain't using the antifreeze like we should. Metaphorically speaking, 2 Timothy 2 and 15. Study to show thyself approved unto God, yourself approved unto God, a workman that needs not to be ashamed, but rightly dividing the word of truth. See, don't just give me the facts, give me the truth. See, people always talk about facts this, facts that, but what is the truth? See, I mean, ask a drug dealer that, say, let's just say, there's a person that sells drugs, or, and they get caught. And the police officer cannot, has no evidence to catch them or anything like that, and they can't catch them. So what happens is they plant drugs and they go and they tell the judge and they say, Judge, when we found him, he had drugs on him. That is a fact because they placed it there. But what is the truth? You put it there. And see, that's what happens in life. We believe facts more than we believe truth. Some people say facts. Yeah, but let's really get to the truth. Don't you really want to know the truth about God and not just what people were saying? See, because if you really read this word, it will tell you about people. It'll tell you about God's people, people that are in the church, people that's outside the church. It'll tell you about that. That's why it says everybody says, Lord, Lord, ain't going to heaven. I'm telling you, if you read this, it'll set you apart. You will have the peace to pass all understanding. 2 Timothy 3 and 17. Catch this as a message version. Through the word, we are put together and shaped up for the task God has for us. Why would we not read the Bible when the Bible is basic instructions before leaving earth? How are we going to pass a test of life if we don't study? Matthew 4 and 4. But he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds out the mouth of God. John 16 and 13, it says, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whosoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he shall show you things to come. Don't y'all want to know the truth? Don't y'all want to know the truth about people that come into your life? Don't y'all want to know the truth about things that happen? See, we just don't want to know the facts, but we want to know the truth, and we know why people did certain things or whatever, why people act a certain way. But I'm telling you, this is why I tell you to read your word. Nah, go try it out yourself. The Bible says that. It says taste and see. I'm just telling you. I'm not telling you about something I was taught. I'm telling you about something I know, something I learned, something I said. I'm going to dig in. I'm going to ask God, and I'm like, God, I want to know this. Make the scripture come real. And God showed me that. There's people that walk away from God and people that in God and doing everything. They can do whatever they want to do. And like this one pastor said, and it makes so much sense. He said, God is the only person that will hire you, fire you, and still allow you to work. If you catch that, you wonder why some people are still acting up. But God is something else. So I'm going to tell you on that note. I'll see you in the next segment. Love y'all.